And welcome here to Texas Motor Speedway. Your host Aaron Douglas joining the booth here with Connor Meyer today.
Hello.
And we have the finale on Speed Channel at Texas Motor Speedway, qualifying from 11th through 40th has been set. However, we have the qualifying still to determine for our top 10 of the chase drivers. All 10 cars have lined up at the front of the field. We're going to start off with walking up right now is the number 36 car of Joey Sanders out of Supreme Motorsports. He's welcoming up and onto the stage, starting to coin out, and he is going to get position number 7. Joey Sanders in the 36 car will start in the 7th spot. The next car is going to be Aaron Douglas out of the Western Auto Racing Organization. He won here at the first chase race. Number 21, Parts America Dodge, is going to be starting 3rd tonight. He's in the 3rd position. Next car is Kyle Keith in the number 42 car out of Keith Motorsports. He's going to be signed the pole position. Kyle Keith starting on the pole position tonight. Next up is going to be another Dodge. This is Big Man out of Manco Motorsports. And for the number 5 car, the Auto Insurance Dodge is starting in the 5th position. My bad, he's in the 8th car. I don't know why it's 5. And we have next is Scott Porter, the number 24 car. This is another Keith Motorsports car. Drawing the coin out, he starts in the 9th position. Now that technically is also going to be the last car tonight in the last position, because what normally would have been the 10th spot, the number 27 car, Vanessa Johnson, failed post-qualifying and we started last using an illegal engine. She had to swap engines out. Next one is going to be the number 60 of Ryan DeLusso, one of the only Team Motorsports cars in the final 10. He is going to start in the 6th position. That is the 6th car in 60. And next one is going to be Brett Pritchard, defending champion, and the number 51 car out of Meyer Toyota Racing. Racing is Bang Energy Toyota. He starts 2nd. He'll be in the 2nd spot next to Kyle Keith. Next is going to be his teammates. That is Caitlin Marie in the number 92, another car out of the Meyer Toyota Racing Organization. Lots of the one of the 3 Toyotas racing tonight in the chase. She's going to be in the 4th spot. So that is going to be the 4th spot for the number 92. And one of the last ones we have is the number 12 car. This is going to be for Aaron Gabron. He is going to be starting in the final spot available. Of course, that's going to be the 8th spot for Aaron Gabron. We'll leave this away. Go ahead and finish that off, Connor Meyer.
And first of the non-chasers, starting 10th, is the number 30 of Chris Moore, alongside the number 1 of Thor Gunderson.
And behind that we have number 9 car, that's Benjamin Thomas out of Lubricar Motorsports, Brad Smith, following student 22.
And then we have the 00 of Andrew Weisbecker and the 77 of Jonathan Reigns.
Tied the short ladder, follows up right behind him, and then it's the 63 of Brandon Crasta.
Number 18 of Chris Davis starts next, alongside the 86 of Arthur Xavier.
Quinn Izzo in that number 95, Double Mint Camry, starts next to Elusive Man in the 28 for Manco Motorsports.
And then the number 10 of Austin Yoakum and the 91 of Tim Salmon.
Kevin Campbell starts next to Luis McClure in the number 87 for Western Auto Racing.
the 55 of Russ Blackwell, and the 62 of Joseph Onesta.
Scott Vickers in that 37 Toyota will be starting next to Connor Meyer in the 29.
And this is 79 of Justin Osborne, and the number 2 of Big Rick Johnson.
Behind them, we got Evan Coward and J.R. Lemon and his 5 for Keith Motorsports.
The 72 of Kenny Bambera, the 99 of Todd Castile.
Behind Castile, we got Langelier and Trent McPherson.
And the 15 of David Walsh and the 35 of Timmy Weathers.
And that course, that car in last, and this is Johnson for the illegal engine. We started in the 40th spot.
Dodge showed up already trying to push the limits.
You got to display getting into the season. Of course, you want every chance you possibly can. But hey, something like that, of course, is going to get caught. Final race of the season. Make your prediction now. Who do you think is going to get it?
As hard as it's going to be to beat the 51 of Brett Pritchard, I think the number 8 of Big Man has the best chance.
He's got certainly a fast car. He's always there when it counts when it comes to these big races. Not to point fingers or anything, but I've got eyes on those purple cars. I really, really like those purple cars. We have the Caitlin Murray in the 92 and the 21 of Aaron. Both of those cars are really consistent when they need to be. So we have 84 laps tonight at this Texas Motor Speedway. Final night race of the season, of course, with this chase, defending title, Brett Pritchard going towards getting his 4th championship in a row in the Farker Racing season. Dodge and Toyota both have 1 win each going throughout the chase. Chevy managed to make 3 cars get in at the last minute. 2 of those are Keith Motorsports cars. We have 1 Ford from Gibron. So we have 1 Ford in there. He got well on the qualifying selection. He wasn't too bad in practice. Think he could possibly have a chance at this too?
I mean, if he can keep people out of trouble, there's always a chance. The Fords really show their strength on super speedways. But I think they have a good chance.
Really hoping for these guys. I mean, it could be something that's really, really interesting about it. Could be quite the upset for him to pull. Just say, even if they don't manage to win tonight, of course, these cars have been running very strong. Teams prepared well for this race. Even if he does or doesn't, I mean, that's quite a low amount of wins and amount of consistency that he would pull out of his rear end for this championship. So, very plausible for Gibron tonight at Alpine Motorsports.
But it'll be interesting to see, though, if, like, the Toyotas work with other Toyotas and Dodge with Dodge. Because if that starts happening, he's all by himself.
Always so for it. But kind of cool to see the would-be quote-unquote underdog for it. say for another car, a team that hasn't done this before. A big pack up. These cars are ready to rock and roll for this. 84 laps at Texas Motor Speedway. We have trouble chase drivers involved immediately. Wow, that looked like that was the Dodge of Manco Motorsports. Big damage to the 92. Let's figure out what happened there. Immediately going into the first corner. I mean, we saw this earlier in the season. They weren't patient at all with it, but let's see just who started what. Looks like they got kind of out of line. The 8 car, he moved out. They were 3 wide. The 60, it was DeLusso of Team Motorsports, went and cut down, made it 4 wide. And of course, just for me, 4 wide across this turn is not enough room. They both collect together. They get into the 92. Man, it ends so soon for that.
Yeah, that's upsetting to see.
19 of Jay Langelier. There's another wreck appears that happened after that. He's pulling his car down. NASCAR making him pull through right now. Not sure what's going on with that. Another wreck appears to have happened after that. Not sure entirely what is going on there. Non-chasers involved with that. I'll tell you what, who's lucky though, the 51 for avoiding that. He has got quite the reputation to uphold.
Yeah, the 50, he was in right in front of that accident whenever it happened. But we spent all that time talking about Ford and Gabron was involved.
Well, I guess that kind of wraps up how their season's been going. He's not, like, hurt, but he's just shy of the top 10 right now. So he still has plenty of time to recover and get back up there. That separate accident, cars pulled off, 35, 19, 99, 83, and 2, all exited the racing surface. The 8 car of Man is currently sitting in the A spot, the 60 car in the 20th spot, 92 with considerable damage is towards last. The 27 car, amidst all of those, that huge debacle of issues in 4 laps, she's now in the 26th spot. Quite an interesting start. I mean, they just gave no room. They couldn't make it to the line without giving each other any room.
That's what happens when, you know, you get too impatient that soon. Because the 60 was wasting no time, and then you see what happens.
Well, you were just thinking about talking about Big Man. And related, not Chase Driver, but Scott Vickers, another Toyota, pulled off the racing surface right now. Looks like it may be an engine or transmission issue going on.
That might have happened when he was trying to avoid the accident.
Happens.
Yeah,
Yeah, Dodge went from having all those cars up there to now just one leading.
I know, that's kind of going to be a concern for them. They got to down to just one vehicle, apart from the 8, to have to worry about. There's another car that looks like that's Chris Morris, 30. Not sure why he's coming down with the 1 to go. Those two spots will help out Big Man, though, that's for sure.
30 might be trying to have some extra damage from that accident. Because he was right behind the 12.
Get ready to go green once more. 21 takes this.
Keep it together.
Yeah, we'll find out. Another Manco Motorsports car is peeking the outside and defend that outside. That's Thor Gunderson. Braun making quick advances. And the wall, that was Connor Meyer. It seems like they're just overdriving it tonight. Look, he's knocking on the back door of that Dodge. There's two of them right there.
Now the 36 and the 51. The last two Toyotas in this.
Doing what they can. Here comes the Keith Motorsports powerhouse right behind them.
And there's the 12 making his way back up in.
There goes Sanders to the lead. He's trying to. The 21's got that outside, though. LeBron's back up here, of course. The Big Man's now got past all the traffic.
Looks like the 36 might clear the 21 here.
He's going to try. It looks like I believe he will, and there he goes. He'll lead this lap, too. That's Joey Sanders. Now is the current runner in the championship.
Here comes those two Chevys.
Keith Motorsports cars, man, they are fast. They are smart for sticking together like the way they have. Twenty-one pushing the 36 out of the corner, trying to go for the slingshot here. He's now towards the inside of that 36 car. Wow, here comes Scott Porter.
The eight car has gained just a little bit that lap.
He slowly is. Look at the shuffle right there. Wow. But he slowly and slowly has. I'll be keeping an eye on it myself. Porter that time around has the fastest lap by 0.1 of a second. He has got quite the fast car tonight. Benners and Pritchard, those Toyotas, have gained back together again. out of drafting with the slower car, Chris Moore, to get around him.
Kind of just single file right now.
Probably smart to do at this point, just to kind of ride out and not cause a crash. That's not going to be on the mind though for the 24. He tries to move his way around the 51. His teammate falling right behind him. Ron as well. Fifty-one's able to make that car as wide as he can, though. He's been blocking both sides to retain that position. Very good driving from the veteran driver. Check up on the rest of the field. Nissa Johnson also, she has worked her way up. She is catching up to Big Matt. She's got a fast car. Elusive Man and Jonathan Reigns surprisingly leading the regulars right now. Wow. Check that out.
Definitely an interesting combination right there.
On recatching to help his teammate out in 36.
The 51 was able to block the 24 and the 42, kind of slow them down, and is now caught back up to the 36.
I've just been kind of like putting things together here, not intentionally being quiet than we normally are. I've been watching a lot of these cars as they have been. They have the 8 and the 27 now catching lap by lap. However, they've reversed that. They are now pushing away, but they're racing differently than the 8 and the 27 are. 8 and 27 working on their own, racing their own line, racing each other. Notice how these cars have hooked up almost like in tandems. And you saw right there, there's a 24 under the corner, push the 51. They're almost like they're super speedway racing right now.
See, I think they're probably trying to get as much distance away from the 8 and the 27 so they can catch up.
That leaves 6 of these championship cars up here, which is better for all of them, as they all would know, because you're dealing with 2 other less chase drivers. Apart from the ones that were involved in wreck, of course, earlier, but hey, I mean, this is a really interesting strategy that they're starting to play out.
The 60 has gotten back to 9th now.
I did not notice that. Very good. He is actually still about 6 or 7 seconds off.
Front group is kind of reshuffled a little bit.
Bump there from the 36 to the 21. Notice the 51 peeks out every now and then just to kind of check and cool off. He's been the only car to do that, so that's good reliability. Well, almost with contact on the 24 car there. That's going to help Gibran if he decides to, yep, follow underneath him. But that also puts the Keith Motorsports cars together. Look at him pushing their bumpers locked through the corners.
And now extends that gap back to the 8th car about 5 seconds now.
Probably leaders to check out those four racing cars, but man, they're catching lap traffic. Here's where things like this start to come into play. Here's the 92 and 62. Both of these cars have teammates. Most 62 have a teammate up here. Here's where we want to watch and see what they will play out. We've seen Dodges block other Chevys, so allowing them to dodge the pass before. That's one of the reasons how Aaron won Charlotte. So let's see what the favors return. Is then two going to block 21 to allow the Toyota to pass? She's going to block them both to allow the 51 to recatch. Let's see. Going into the corner, she does. She does. She blocked 21's movement. Ruined the speed there. Just when I figured that what would happen. Now they both go to pass. 36 is pushing. Will the 62 block again going to the corner? Because he needs the 60 car to catch. That he does. Now they're blocked between two lapped cars. This is going to slow all the chasers down.
I'm going to let the second group to start catching again.
We'll see how they scored going around that last lap. They did a whole second they made up that lap. Just because of those two cars. Sanders making a move. He's able to get a 21 high, but not enough to get underneath him. That was enough to allow most
he
of those cars.
A few different times.
Well, another thing too is those Dodges front and back are flat. Those Toyotas are not. They're round. It's very hard to be receiving a push from a car like that. Keeping an eye on the others, they are still up there. Nissa Johnson back by 5.91. The 42 starting to lose a little bit, but he's not exactly off the pace, I would say. Next car's a lap down, they would catch. It's the 95. Yeah, they're about to catch the field. These cars have just been racing so hard up here. Let's make it a little interesting as they run around halfway. 36 again, trying to get underneath the 21. 21 doesn't get out this corner, though. 51 right behind him, but leaves him out. Scott Porter, that 24 car, we noted him earlier as the one of the fastest cars on the racetrack. He still is. Both of those Keith Motorsports cars are dubbed as the fastest ones.
Think you want to be leading into and just like that the 42 popped back up.
just like that, a little bit of a slip up. Again, right back to those Toyotas. They're really strong with holding them off. Not bad at all, those Keith cars. They're really trying to keep the 12 in catch up at the same time. Big man, 27. 60 as well. Elusive man, still leading that pack. Impressive job and a really good run for him today. Crashed it, not bad at all either.
This is one of Crass's probably best runs in a while.
It has been since he blew the motor leading. Thor getting some trouble there with the 5 car. A lot of these guys still racing hard. Want to do the best for their sponsors before the end of the season. Luis, he's kind of just chilling right now. He's been announced he will not be returning next year. This is his chance for him to show to another team. Here they are. This is the chance for the turners to move around what they can. Another Western Auto car out with Trent McPherson. Sanders and Brett staying right to that back bumper, sucked up. And look at the 15, David Walsh, right in front of the 21 there.
Almost like it was planned.
Yeah, exactly. And Aaron has to shut the 36 out on the first chance he gets. Very good help. I'm in trouble. A 29 car. Engine blowing behind him across the front straightaway. Big wreck. Team Salmon involved. Here comes some other chase drivers in the wall. It's Anissa and the 8. Other cars trying to avoid it. Wow, I'm not sure what happened there.
Yeah, no, that's crazy.
I think something let go major. Because he was slowing down and then got rear-ended. Right as the... Wow, they got lucky. The leaders almost got involved with that. Porter, Gabron, Keith all narrowly missed that wreck. Parts flying around. Here comes the race within the race as we head onto pit road. All cars having to come down. I don't know if he was out of gas or what, but wow.
Something unfortunate happened.
Look at that. Not sure as to why, The 12 car has been announced. It's going to the garage. That's Gibran, a chase car, having to go to the garage. And he has exited the race. He's out of the car. Not sure team underneath the hood, trying to figure out what's going on. They put the car on Jax. 36, now the highest chase
That's
driver.
Unfortunate.
It's very unfortunate. That was
both him and Ford.
Very strong run from Ford today, trying to get a championship in, but man, it's reliability all season long.
A decent chunk of cars between the 36 and the 21.
I mean, quite the slowdown difference between on that pit stop there. 21's back three cars. 24 was able to get around the 51. At least 7's now up there, so she's going to have a chance to run at this. It'll be interesting. This will be interesting.
Seven and the eight both have that right side damage, though.
So that's also the halfway point. Sanders leading at the halfway. No point awarded. Straight to the highest finisher, of course. But it is something to reflect upon as we get closer to the end of this thing. It is Toyota, Dodge, Chevy, Toyota. Chevrolet. Dodge. Toyotas are the ones ending up having a little bit of a struggle today, along with Ford. But as we get closer, this green flag is about to come out. The 36 car, lapper 93 ahead of him, with the chance for it. Head down into the corner. 36 immediately takes big advantage of having that outside 21, 24 going right behind him. And we have another flag. 22 car in the fence. Ace car involved. 8 car big man is involved with this wreck. We are under caution.
The 8.
This is the 8. That is big man of Marico Motorsports, one of the other few Dodges that was up here. And would you look at what happened? That is the 28 car of the Lucid Man. to watch here. Ooh. 92. It's hard to tell. This may just be a racing incident because 92 is cutting down. 28 holding his line. 62 also hit with that. Damn, and look at her car was riding on top of the safer barrier. Final, that's pretty much going to be the final nail in the coffin for that 92 car tonight.
Definitely not the race they were looking for.
Still out on track. That kind of resets our top four chasers, 36, Joey Sanders, Scott Porter, Aaron Douglas, and of course, defending champion, Brett Pritchard. How ironic, this is kind of what we were depicting where this was going to end up with. A lot of these drivers were strong all season.
Definitely. Can you ever count on the 51?
Of course, but I was expecting he had to be up there.
The 63 is running 8th.
So you have two other Toyotas up here. I mean, you've got kind of more of the in-car perspective of this. Are you guys like feeding different advice to them during the pit stops? Has there been like sharing a pit strategy? What have you guys been doing to get both of those Toyotas up there?
I'm definitely trying to keep them on the same page for sure. With pit stops and all that. And it seems to be working out considering those cars really haven't left each other.
Been very good, especially with Sanders. I mean, I'm honestly not surprised Sanders has been up here leading for the majority of this because of how dominant he did this season points wise.
But even though the 36 and the 51 kind of had like a rough stretch in the middle of the season, they definitely worked it out to get to Texas and then have a chance to win it. Is she with the 21?
Not sure what's going on. Saw he's pulled off the racing surface. Not yet going green. This is even an idle. So this feels like a loose wheel.
This is definitely not the time for that.
No, it's halfway into one of the most important races that it possibly could be. And especially right now, when they're about to go green, this is pretty much going to eliminate this chase day. That is going to be the last potential I guess I won't say last potential dodge, those 27 post something ever, but two of the three.
And the 27 does have damage.
It does, but she's not going to be in the sixth spot, not far ahead. And these cars are slower. So we'll just have to see what goes on as we take the green flag. Chris Sanders, Scott Porter, Brett Pritchard lead us to the green. A couple of lappers, three wide right behind them. Let's see, there's three chase cars, what they will do. 78, that teammate of the 27 holds up the 60 car. They know they have problems with their team. They got to get him up there.
Both the 42, the 60, and the 27 are stuck in this traffic.
42, 60, and 27 are able to find the bottom line. They just need to continue to hold that through, and they can catch those leaders. We may have more cars in with this mess, and they do. Hang on, 21 coming back to the racetrack. Taps down and see if he can make an effect on those other two chase cars. Will he try to hold them up? Coming out of this corner, needs to hold and stay out of the way, and he does. Brett Pritchard goes to the inside, trying to go for the lead. We have a caution, not sure what is going on, but the caution flag is out. That's going to reset the field. Big mess involving, it looks like, Brad Smith and, again, Caitlin Marie in the 92 car involved in a tangle. Looks like the 22 of Brad Smith crowded Luis McClure. What's left of Big Man's car? A hard hit from Justin Osborne and Jonathan Raines. 92 plows into the 28s. Benjamin Thomas involved. Chris Davis involved. That's a hard lick. Let's go full speed with somebody who miraculously didn't get too much damage on that one. Check this out. Great driving there by Onesto.
Yeah, the 22 pinballed off the 77, and
he did. Yeah,
that was.
And between him and the 97, he just kept going around and around. Hopefully he's all right. Look at the situation it's created up here.
All those chasers are together again.
27 car. Not sure where that car scored. 11th. I'm not sure what happened there. May have pitted.
As the field gets smaller. Eight cars still being scored ninth?
Yes. Wow. How did he manage to do that? That car has no front end. He legit just has a splitter and fenders on it. Just enough to keep it compliant. Amazing.
Weight reduction.
Weight reduction, bro. That's outstanding move. I wonder how long that will last. Just being in the top 10 alone, that's impressive.
Hey, if something happens to the top 5 chasers, there he goes.
Huh. Currently 2 Dodges not in the top 10 with this chase. One of them badly damaged. Sanders and defending champion Pritchard leading this thing. Two of the Keith Motorsports cars, three of three Chevrolets are up here currently. Chevrolet and Toyota flexing their dominance right now. Dodge trying to make a comeback within the last 30 laps. Boys and girls, we still got a show. Well, of the cars that are now, like, you know, not out, I've got strong confidence for the 51 car. What about you?
I'm putting all my faith in the 36.
You're going Joey
really
Sanders?
That I think the first-time rookie can pull it off.
A rookie for Farca, who won the points battle, for the most part was winless.
Did have one win at Dover, where he led every lap.
Dominated fashion. He has the most laps led of any driver this season, 95 laps before this race started. Second was Anissa with 92. So we get ready to go green again. So I get where you're coming from there. He's got all the reasons. And there goes Brett Pritchard, right as I was talking, straight to the inside. Scott Porter, Kyle Keith following there. Connor, will you stop calling out cars? You would think you're going to win.
You know, I think that 21 car is going to come back and win it.
Hey, now! Reverse that! Here comes...
I'm going to leave that prediction where it's at.
That didn't last very long at all. There comes 24, Scott Porter, 42. Keith Motorsports trying to dominate this thing. 27, keep an eye on her. She's moved up as well as the 8 still retains the 9th spot. Don't count those Toyotas out so early, though. They always work their way back up. Kyle trying to move around his teammate.
No, 27 still has some speed in it. I think she could win.
I don't know if you're being sarcastic or not, because she is She is moving up really fast. In fact, she is gonna catch
Apparently.
These guys. She's in 6th.
You said I was cursed, though, so...
Yeah, but look, she's got one more car to get... Well, Chris! Temple, get out of the way! Thank you! Probably too far back to catch. And... Keith Motorsports, Chevrolet's leading this thing, dominating.
I mean, can they be dominating if they've only led, like, 3 collective laps? Those Chevys are really fast. I think they could win today.
Man, Chevys... I don't know, because they're so back and forth. They're there when they need to be, and then something happens. Yet they... somehow managed to do something right at the end. That is such an inconsistent manufacturer. 3 wide for the lead into turns 1, then there's contact. 42 makes contact with the 36 to shut him out. Scott Porter has nowhere to go with no grip on the outside. Joey Sanders trying to hold the inside entering turns 3 and 4. The 21 of Aaron Douglas and the 51 of Brett Pritchard fall right behind. Again, we just mentioned their consistency and look what happened.
You know, I have a bad feeling that the 21 is just going to dump somebody.
He is in a Dodge. But the 51 pushing him into the corner right now. They've been good lately, but let's bring up Knoxville again. Should we dwell in the Knoxville?
When the Dodges decided to lose all their stuff and wreck everybody.
They decided to wreck everybody, including themselves. Anissa Johnson is catching this pack, the 21, trying to make a move and get around 36 car. And there he goes. I think that's the second time Dodges led tonight. That is the 21 car of Aaron Douglas. Brett Pritchard falling right behind and can't prevent the 21 car from leading a lap. That's going to be the next part.
The 21's a lap down.
Are you kidding me? I've been not paying attention.
Yeah, remember he had that issue on a pit stop.
Whatever issue.
Caution.
Why has that had to happen? Brett Pritchard doing a fantastic job of leading right now.
Yeah, so just ignore the 21.
The 21 car. He is invisible. He is holding the field up to allow the 27 car to catch, which, if you look closely, she's been gaining about a point and a half every second, every lap, point and a half, point and a half.
Hits wall.
Hits. Don't you even talk right now. She lost a point and a half because of that. That is your fault, Connor.
Hits wall again.
No, stop. Brett Pritchard blows the engine.
It doesn't work that way.
We'll see. Scott Porter going for the lead here. They've caught up to elusive and that badly damaged Dodge.
What's left of the 28?
What is left? That's pretty easier to say. What is he doing? Don't wreck the chase drivers.
It's a Dodge.
It is a Dodge, but wow. Porter not retaining the lead after the shenanigans pulled by Elusive Man.
Just imagine if that 21 was on the lead lap right now.
Would have been fantastic. However, thankfully the 27 was able to catch from that. Whether that was planned or not, we are not going to confirm nor deny.
It's Walt.
You be quiet over there.
The gap to the 27 now is less than a second. The 8 car is still in 8th.
I don't know how. Because that car is so badly damaged. I don't understand how. Brett has gotten
fast enough to keep up with the non-chasers.
I mean, there he is right there along with Titus. It was in 7th. And then... the non-chaser seems to have settled down for the most part. This little pack right here, which I'm not going to say anything because that 95 car has been trying to wreck me before. Maybe with a different driver, that car still has a bad reputation.
Yeah, some of those Dodges. Dodges like to wreck.
Well, how does 4 races and 3 DNFs sound?
I mean, the 87 and the 72 are in that pack, and not the 72, the 78.
Yes.
They like to wreck each other.
He is one of the worst. As far as retaliations go, at least. 27 is caught in the draft with this pack. Question is, with that amount of damage, can she be competitive?
You know, speaking of the 72, is he still in this?
Kenny Bambura in the 72 like car is in 20th, a lap down.
But still not DNF'd.
Not DNF'd. There's, we're down to just 27 cars in this thing. One of those cars, Chase Fairbanks, is 92. And she ended up finishing the 31st spot.
That's what happens when a Dodge wrecks you.
That's what happens when you come across the nose of a Dodge and try to hit a Chevy.
Speaking of Chevy, the 24 still leads.
24 does. Kyle Keith trying to now retain second back, violently passing around the 51 car.
Yeah,
things are going to start getting a little heated here. However, that 24 car's got quite a good little gap. Oh, close contact there, 27 to the 60. This right here is all the way for second. 24 is behind the 21. Need to gather it up just to catch that car.
Yeah, but Keith is doing everything he can to slow down these cars.
That three wide right here. This is just for second place right now. I don't understand why they're battling like this. They need to get to Porter. Porter's running away with this thing.
Well, we know the 27's catching up, and that's the end of fun.
It's the end of fun. The only thing I can really see changing this is if they gather it up or we get another caution.
Well, they're catching that cars again. They're running up on the 62.
That could definitely change things, but that is also a Chevy. That car's way off pace. Yeah, no, not even a chance. Porter went right around. Man, it's over a second right now. Porter is just flying. Coming to 12 laps to go right here. Where you kind of struggling with these other cars right here. Next car lap down is the 86. That is just too much time.
That's a big gap.
I think Porter, unless for some reason he's... Oh, hang on. Hold your tongue. I don't like this. That was a little too close for comfort there.
All that did is slow that group down again.
It did. I was going to say, unless the 62 caused a wreck there, which he almost did. But we'll see if this singled out will help them with draft. It is now almost 3 seconds.
The 36 and the 51 are going to try to work together.
They're trying, however, the 27 is moving around in front of the 36. The 51, in clean air, has speed. But still, Scott is just flying. I don't think there's any catching him right now. I think they left that car in reserve. Comes up another slow car, this one being a Dodge. This is Elusive Man. And there we go, the Dodge is blocking the Chevy. This is where something may be crucial. Not enough. They tried. It only was able to hold them up by 1 point of a second. They tried. They're coming up to more. They will actually catch the 86. 24 has got so much speed.
He
he's had a lot of speed all year.
And again, the consistency of these cars. We're talking about going up and down, up and down, and then being there when it counts. We'll see how it is going across this line. That is still quite the gap that we have. And it's back to gaining again, that one by quite a handful. Here's where the next worry comes, that is almost the point of next flag into the race. Running an engine this hard, one of my watchdog wonders in the back of my head, and it's because it's happened to both the 24 and the 42 before, and it hasn't happened yet today, is a Chevrolet engine failure.
They blocked by... slowed them a little bit.
They try. They keep, every time those two drivers get side by side, they really try.
Cars came down for pit stops, though.
We'll have to see. Wonder if there is a fuel window going on here. That's the 88 Titus. Almost about to come to the white flag. 87 as well. Porter, now here's where we're going to do the watch. He's been racing hard and he's got lap traffic. The next question is, did he save? Does he have time? Can they catch with lap traffic? It's a 3-second gap. But it's quite a slow gap that's going on. White flag is in the air. Scott Porter, it's almost a home free shot, but he has got such slow traffic behind him. See one rounding the corner around him. I don't think it's enough time despite the traffic. Into turns 3 and 4, we finally get a new champion. At Texas Motor Speedway, Scott Porter of Keith Motorsports takes the checkered flag. Second place, Brett Pritchard. Kyle Keith finishes in third, team owner of the champion. Anissa Johnson fourth. Joey Sanders finishes fifth. 60, a team Motorsports finishes in sixth. Big Man manages to finish in eighth. Benjamin Thomas gets out of nowhere. Benjamin Thomas, top 10. Andrew Weisbecker, ninth. Thor Gunderson, top 10. Almost like I want to say
it's the first time we've had a new champion.
Of course, congratulations to him. Being the new champion. Second place runner-up to defend his title. Nice job for Brett Pritchard for holding his own today. He has been outstanding every single year. Every year that man has been putting on an excellent effort. Scott Porter out of Keith Motorsports wrangling up again, finally getting Keith Motorsports into victory lane once more and defending the championship. I mean, that's going to be huge from rolling into next year, especially since they finished first and third in the points for the chase. 27, what a way for for her to retire out of the season. Getting a top five. Sanders putting on a valiant effort for Toyota despite all of the ups and downs Toyota had all race long. They finished second and fifth in the championship tonight. I'm sure you were really hoping for something to happen there with the 24, but are you guys still humble with finishing second?
Yeah, as much as you would win, you know, four straight championships, I mean, congrats to the 24 and Chevy. We thought it was going to be down between Toyota and Dodge, and Chevy kind of came out of nowhere and won it.
Not bad. I'm not going to lie. I was really hoping for Brett Pritchard. It's so hard to retain championships like that. And part of me is like, yeah, that's really cool, really cool. Keep that up. And it's like, I'm really happy for Scott Porter. That team more than deserved it. They were always there when it needed to be.
There's always next season for Brett to win another championship.
I wouldn't doubt it if we can, especially since we're going to that new body style, which you guys will be seeing a variation of that very soon. Once again, big congratulations to Scott Porter. You are the 2019 Farca Racing Series champion. That also leads him into the lower position of what will be coming up soon, and that is FROC, the Farca Race of Champions. We have six races of a championship within a championship. Any previous Farca Racing champion is eligible for this, and any race winner of the past season. We got just a little over, I believe, just a little over or shy of 10 cars. Six races, all big tracks. Will be very interesting to see how these cars will go and who will win this. Quite the turnout we had again here tonight. It's never a boring race here at Texas Motor Speedway. Quite the wrecks and events that we had leading up to this, and then the dominating fashion that the 24 showed at the end. They had the pit strategy correct. They had enough fuel in the car to make it towards the end, and they definitely showed that off with the speed they displayed at the end. Congratulations again to Scott Porter. Thank you again, Brett Pritchard, for everything you've also done for this. And you did a great job. Almost got a championship again today. Toyota and Chevy definitely led the show. On to next season. What's your excitement for?
These new cars are definitely going to be a lot of fun. That and then, you know, all the upcoming, you know, team changes and sponsor changes. It's gonna look a lot different.
You want to announce the new secondary series, and this is now going to be renamed to the Premier Series. So what is our secondary series?
So as of right now, there is talks about bringing a truck series back.
So the truck series, it's been quite a while since we've had a truck series, but almost about 4 to 5 seasons since we ran a truck series, and it was a pretty small one. It retained just the short tracks, but there were the talks of what we've been going on is one almost in tandem with the part of the main schedule with a few here and there, different weekends. So something for drivers to look forward to, and something teams can also develop other drivers in. I think it'll be something interesting.
Yeah, definitely. It's going to be, you know, almost every 2 weeks instead of every week like the main series is. But it's going to be a shorter schedule, but with a lot of the same tracks.
So a lot of these teams can work on their cars, develop drivers, and get them ready for the next season, and then also fight within another chase for another big grand prize. With that, we thank you guys for another amazing series. This was the fourth and conclusion to the fourth season of Farca. We will see you guys this fall for FROC. Thank you guys. We'll see you at the next one.